Bam! We are going to find the Cartesian equation of the plane alpha if it contains the point negative 2, 1, 3, and the line, which is given to us in Cartesian form of x minus 3 equals y plus 1 over 3, which is equal to z. What do you need to write the equation of a line? What do you need to write the equation of a plane? Well, whether you're going to go into Cartesian form or not, you need a point on the plane, whether you're going to use this form or this form for the equation of a plane in vector format. You need a point on the plane described with this position vector, and you need some kind of gradient, whether that gradient is two vectors, the sum of two vectors which are parallel to the plane, or you're using a vector which is orthogonal. We're going to do the orthogonal one in this video since we just got done doing, well, we used both methods in our last example, but I focused on the one where we used the parallel vectors, or we use the first form. So we're going to write this, we're going to break this apart into, from Cartesian into the three parametric forms, or that combination of those three parametric equations making up or describing this line. So we have x minus 3 is equal to lambda. We have y plus 1 over 3 is equal to lambda. And we have that z is equal to lambda. And just to make this really, really clear, we're going to make each one of these look identical so we can clearly see what at least one point, you know, we can find one point along this line very, very easily, and then find a direction vector or sort of a gradient for that line. So we're going to write this as x minus 3 over 1. We got this already really good. Y plus 1 over 3 again is equal to lambda. And here we're going to write that z minus 0 over 1 is equal to lambda. So we can see that the line that they gave us has a point, let's just call it A, which has the coordinates of 3, negative 1, 0, and a directional vector, a gradient, if you will, for this line is in the denominator. Or we can see it, actually, I could have done that. I could have multiplied this by 3 and then subtracted 1. I'll show you that as well. I'll just do it on here. X is equal to 3 plus lambda. Coming down here, multiplying by 3 and subtracting by 1, we have y is equal to negative 1 plus 3 lambda. And we have z is equal to 0 plus lambda. So however you look at it, whether it's moving in towards writing this in this middle step of going into our parametric equations, or just solving each of these for x, y, and z, which honestly is better now that I'm saying this, but we can see that point again of 3, negative 1, 0 here, and lambda is that scalar multiple of our gradient or directional vector, which is going to be 1, 3, and 1. So now we know a point and a direction. Okay, so it gave me a second to check my answer while my wonderful wife was answering the phone. We now know for this plane alpha, one point that is on the plane, and we have this other point, which is also in the plane because the plane contains the line, and we have a direction vector. Well, whether we're going to use a normal vector or equation or the just regular sort of vector form for the equation of a plane, we need two non-collinear vectors. And right now we only have one sort of gradient or directional vector for our plane, so we need another one. Well, we have that. We have two points that are in the plane. So we can find vector AP, which is going to be terminal minus initial, negative 2 minus 3, 1 minus negative 1, and 3 minus 0. And so we have vector AP is equal to negative 5, 2, and 3. So we have a point, and we have two non-collinear directional vectors that are together the gradient of this plane. And these are not scalar multiples of each other, so they're not parallel. thus they wouldn't be useful. Now I just want to make sure that I haven't wrote an incorrect number because I did some mental math incorrectly. Okay, now we're going to find the equation of this plane by going through the normal vectors, which we're going to do the cross product between U and AP, which is going to be found, I'll have the answer up there in a second, by setting up a 3x3 matrix. You might have noticed some patterns that you can use to find the cross product vector quicker. I just keep showing this process in case your teacher wants some really like formal work and see that you actually know what's going on, not that you just recognize some pattern and sort of shortcutting this process. But do whatever your teacher is happy with. This is going to be, we want the determinant, this is going to be equal to the determinant of this 3x3 matrix. So again, row, column and row that contains the I taken out. That is going to be a coefficient of our I component minus the determinant. Take out the column and row that has again the J, vector J component, plus the determinant of the 2x2 matrix when you take out the column and row that has the vector component K. One last time, because this is the last example, work out these little 2x2 determinants. We have 9 minus 2, which would be a component for vector I, minus 1 times 3 is 3, minus negative 5. That'll be our component for vector J, plus the determinant of this 2x2 matrix, 2 minus negative 15. And that is going to give us a cross product, which is equal to, I'm going to write this in column component form, 9 minus 2 is 7. We've got 3 plus 5, which is 8, but it's got a negative out here, so negative 8. And 2 plus 15 is 17. Double check one more time, just so we're good for the camera, using that normal vector. We're going to fill in this formula, vector r dotted with our normal vector equals some position vector for a known point on the plane, taking that scalar product or dot product with that normal vector. And we have, and we do want this in Cartesian format. So I'm going to go ahead and take the vector r and replace it with that the component form of x, just x, y, and z, general point on the plane. Dot it with our normal vector, 7, negative 8, 17. We're going to use coordinate A. You know, we can't do this problem without understanding how to find the point and the direction, the gradient of this line. So it's really kind of not a great idea to use information that you found yourself in your work whenever possible, though if this isn't right, the rest of our work isn't right. But you could use, you know, P here, and I could call this the position vector for coordinate P and have negative 2, 1, and 3. I'm going to dot that with our normal vector of 7, negative 8, and 17, and we get 7x. And by the way, I did not use coordinate P in my notes, I use coordinate A that I pulled from the line, but you'll see that we have the same answer. Negative 2 times 7 is negative 14, plus 1 times negative 8 is negative 8, plus we have 30 and 21 is 51, so we're looking at 7x minus 8y plus 17z is equal to negative 22, 29. Double check. And I am thankfully done. If you made it to the end, thank you so much for watching all of these examples. I hope you learned something. And I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.